Hi everyone and welcome to this new video. This in a way is some kind of mini challenge that Miriam just sent over to me. It is not the main challenge that I am going to receive in return of the challenge I sent to her in my last video. This basically is something that she did in her last video and just looked awesome. It was some swirly pour and she asked me to try this on my own and I was really curious about because it looked awesome and I hope I can achieve something quite similar to this. And here you can see all the materials that I'm going to use. This is the colors that I'm going to use. It's all acrylics. These are from Artina, which is a local, it's a German store where I can get my acrylics from. It's via Amazon. This is from my local craft store. It's a magenta, really cool color. These are two metallic colors. And this is the Liquitex Soft Body Acrylic Paint Muted Violet, which is a cool dark color. I did not use any silicone for this. This is just the paint and a little bit of water to make it the consistency that I wanted to have. I only added some medium and I used Floetrol for this, for the metallics and the Liquitex color, because otherwise I would have just needed too much of the color and it, so I just wanted to stretch my color a bit. I have a coffee cup actually, which is not plastic. It is more like this coffee to go cup, like paper stuff, because I can make an edge, which I will need later to pour it. And I have a canvas, just let me get rid of the paint bottles here. So, and this canvas is 30 by 60 centimeters. And I already put some of my pinboard pins underneath to have it elevated from the surface. So here it is. The first base layer is going to be just white. So I mixed quite a cup of white here. Once the canvas is covered in paint, and it's a pretty nice coat already, I can start mixing my colors. And I wanted to create some more or less transition from the bluish tones here over some yellow to the pinkish tones over here. I have no idea if this works, because I have never done this before. I am not sure if I'm not too clumsy to make this swirly motion all over the time to make a somewhat nice looking effect. I don't know. Fully experimental. And I'm pretty sure this is way too much color so that I can fill 5 of these canvases. Probably I will. We will see. So let's just try and give this a shot here. And yes, way too much color. But perhaps we can do another one on the side here. And let's see how this works. Well, there are some pretty areas, there are some boring areas. So let's see what happens if I tilt it to make it perhaps a bit less red. If I can stretch it a bit. And you know what? I really did not like the result in the end. It was pretty in some areas, but most of it was just too, just not what I like watching, actually. So I decided to wash it. I wiped all the color off, cleaned it totally, put a new coat of white onto it, and wanted to try it again with the same color palette. So I mixed a new set of colors, a bit less this time, because last time it was way, way too much, and wanted to do the same color schematic and transition from the one color range to the other. So I mixed it into my cup, poured it over, tried to do controlled circles like Miriam did, and she really did a wonderful job. It looked so easy when she did it, and I just felt failing again. So I don't know if my color was too thin or too thick, or if it just was luck, I don't know. I really had a hard time pouring this color, but the second attempt at least went a bit smoother than the first one. Yes, I could have started and tested it on a smaller canvas, but I think, to be honest, a smaller canvas size would not have saved me, after all. So I poured the colors over it as I did the first time, but a bit more controlled, and I ended up having a somewhat cooler color range. So I had smaller or thinner, let's say thinner swirls than I had in the first time, and the colors were popping through quite nicely. And I think because I used the floor trowel in some of these colors to stretch them, I had some cells. Not really many, because I did not want to have cells in the end anyways, but some of them were popping through and it really was better looking. I was not overall happy jumping around in my flat here, but at least I did not get sick watching it. So I liked it better than the first one. As my pour was really centered in the middle of the canvas, I needed to pour it around a bit more. So I tilted my canvas to all the sides to make the color stretch a bit and to flow over the edges and to make it a somewhat genuine looking design, which in a way worked, but not overall. So the upper corner was still a bit empty and too negative spacey, empty white, which felt a bit boring because the color itself in the middle was etched, so there was not so much feathering into the white and such. So it looked a bit, yeah, not as I hoped it to turn out in the end. As I had some color left in my cups, I decided to do another smaller, tinier pour on the upper edge of the canvas to make it covered a bit and perhaps make it look a bit more completed in a way. If it turned out to be ugly looking, I could have just swiped it off and put white over it again to have it erased. But yeah, I had the color here, wanted to try, and I'm not sure if it looks better in the end. What do you think? Do you think this tiny little thingy in the corner was a good idea to do, or should I have just let it ride? After all, I really liked my second attempt better, and although it was quite easy and simple looking, it honestly takes some practice, I guess, and I'm quite sure I will use this technique again in the future. I should practice on smaller projects first. I don't know. We will see. So please let me know in the comments what you think of my result. Please also have a look at Miriam's result, which was the reference for this attempt here. And I really hope you had fun watching. I had fun messing around with the colors for something new to test out. If you're new to my channel, please make sure to subscribe and leave some comments. Give me a thumbs up if you liked the video. And just to let you know, besides these acrylic pours, I also do realism paintings and drawings and tutorials and how to do's. And so I would love you to subscribe to my channel if you have not already. And look forward to see you in my next video. Have a great day. Bye bye.